Parental discretion is advised for the following program. The Now and Then Show is made possible by assistance from the following businesses. Southern Exposure, taking care of all your hair care needs, located on Main Street in Mendocino. M&J's Home Video Movie Rentals, located on the corner of Lansing and Ukiah Streets in Mendocino.
John Chamberlain, maker of fine signs and poster graphics. Have a great time in Hawaii, John. Aloha. The Louie Louie Band, performing at the Siegel Cellar Bar, Friday, May 8th, 1987. The band Mofoco, performing here and there, now and then.
Now and Then Show.
Of May conjures visions of Mother's Day sales at Macy's, spring flowers, softball practice, and fog in Mendocino. But this month also ushers in the Now and Then anniversary show. Yes, you Bobs. Whether you know it or not, this is the second anniversary show. And you know, it takes a lot to put this gig together. It's not easy. I mean, we have producers, musicians, food. It's hard. It's not easy. But we're going to do it. So, don't tell me. I know. Let me look. Okay. So, this is Mrs. Peterson here saying stay tuned for the next half hour because we've got some really good guests for you guys tonight. Musicians, Lewis Demetri, Garth Beckington, Bugs is here, John Phillips and Randy Stewart. We got big laughs from homegrown comedians Doug Nunn and Tracy Burns. A beautiful belly dancer, Debra Fischbach, is here. And finally, last but not least, the creative force behind all this nutty madness is the retiring producer, Michael L. Evans. So now, please help moi welcome the big, the bad, the Bob, Robert Avery.
Wow, good evening. Welcome. Have you seen the size of our band tonight? Have you really seen the size? This used to be the fundamental Louie Louie Band, but they have cloned themselves tonight. There are now two bass players, two lead guitar players, two drummers, and if Louie plays with both hands, we have the double double band tonight.
Nice hair.
Nice hair too, yeah. Like your hair. Like your hair very much. I'll raise one eye to that, yeah. Welcome.
Like that eye.
Thank you.
I like the eye too. Yeah. This was not a result of an injury. As much you might think. However, tonight we have a wonderful show for you. This is, believe it or not, our second anniversary show. Can you believe we've been here 2 years? 2 years?
No.
Yes? 2 years?
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah, two great years.
Okay, 2 great years. And tonight we have some special things for you. I don't believe you have ever heard Louie the Livid sing, have you? Have you ever heard Louie the Livid sing? Well, we're going to have Louie the Livid sing. We're going to have Garth the Animal is going to sing. Yeah. Debra Fischbach is here, and she is going to dance for us.
Yay!
Yes. And we're going to have a special interview with our producer, Michael O.B. Evans. Yes. And if you wonder what O.B. stands for, you're just going to have to wait a while until we get to that. Yes? Okay. It's going to be a good show. We're going to have fun. It's second anniversary, and the promise for the future is nebulous. But here we go. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Now and Then Show. It's the Now and Then Show. From coast to coast. It's the Now and Then Show. I'm Bob Avery. And this is Peterson, your co-host.
And now, another word from the Tourist Bureau of Australia.
go ahead and throw another shrimp on your own Bobby. Goodbye, mate.
That's not the same thing that happened to me when I kissed a cop on Hollywood and Vine.
What happened?
I'm not talking about it. I was in the history. That's history. That's in the past.
So we're gonna
never mind.
Bruise?
Which bruise? This bruise right here?
Yeah.
Well, no. I hate to talk about that. Really.
It's okay. I understand.
Well, welcome back. Here we are. This is our second anniversary show, and I must apologize for neglecting to mention the fact that Burns and Nunn are going to be here later in the show. When I did my little
way
rap.
To go. It's nerve-wracking, isn't
it?
Hey,
knock it off.
I want to do my part over, Mike.
Okay, you can introduce yourself.
No, I don't want to.
I'd like to introduce my co-host, Kelly Peterson.
Hey!
Tell us what that means.
The mantle
what,
of...
What does this mean, Kelly Peterson?
The mantle of marriage has fallen upon my broad
see?
And strong shoulders.
These are real, too, I think.
Yeah.
Cut out.
They're not bad. Well, how's it feel to be married?
It's wonderful.
Yeah, I
like
it.
You should know.
I do. I like it.
Louie. We're waiting for you. You're next. I'll sing at your wedding, I promise.
Okay.
Now
anyway,
they won't have
Mrs.
one for
Peterson,
sure.
And we're not to be confused with the one that makes coffee on television.
That's
right?
Mrs. Olson, you guys.
Olson. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Great,
I apologize
great,
for all the things I did to you earlier. We have some anniversary cards. Believe it or not, people have written to us after 2 years on the air, and they want to express their sentiments. So we'll read.
Hurry.
We'll read some of these. Okay.
I love
let's hurry and rush along here and open up these sealed cards. Card number one. You're the greatest show in Mendo. Happy second. Hope to see the third year from a couple of party animals, Prime Charles and Lady Di. All the way from England.
Prime
Charles and Lady Di. Would you like to see this? Well, there they are. You can see them.
It's a lovely sediment.
Thank you. I thought so.
I get
that's
the one
sediment number one.
In pink. I get this
all right,
one.
You get to do this one.
The pink one. Pink.
Card number two.
Congratulations. You did it. For another year, love the changes. Is this like from, oh, it is.
Mac's headrest.
Keep it up. You inspire me to no end. Mac's headroom, I'm sure.
Well, show the people. Here, no, you have to show it over here.
Where, that one?
Yeah.
Hi, Max. Thanks for thinking of us.
Great. We should analyze that handwriting. That looks interesting.
What did you say?
Yeah, I think we're back on the track now. I heard that. All right.
Well,
that's two from the same
happy
anniversary.
Per person. Where's the cake?
Later.
I'm saving it.
Here's card number three. You might have been a headache, but you never were a bore.
That's a relief.
Happy second anniversary. Now and then, watch you all as much as you're on. Thanks for the good times. Joan Rivers.
Joni. I knew it.
Joni, darling.
Right. Can we talk Joan things?
Yeah, we can talk.
She thought about
later.
Us.
Later. Your turn.
And the winner is... Break a leg. Happy anniversary. You two are the greatest. They're talking about you, Mikey.
Over here.
Mike and Bob. The orchestra is a monster of music. Love them. Paul Schaefer. Hear that, Louie?
What does this mean, break a leg?
Paul.
Paul, break a leg.
Yeah, what does that mean? Where did that come from? When you say break a leg, which would ordinarily mean something bad, it means good. How did that happen?
Open this one.
I don't know. Philosophy. Forget it. I don't know. Jeez. Oh, my God. Look at this one. Let's. All right. Here we go. You got a shot on this one? Come in here right close. There you go. You got it?
Get me out of
you
it.
You got the glare on?
Mona Lisa.
All right, here we are. Mona Let's Lisa. Party!
Party at Bob's.
Thanks for another year. See you after the show, Mona. Thank you so much, Mona.
Party
That's
at your
really
house
wonderful.
After this, Bob?
No, no, not at my house.
Come
no,
on.
My house is
you
secret.
You have a good house and a good TV.
I do have a good house and good TV.
You can watch yeah. the show.
I have a good wife and a good child, too.
Okay,
dear Bob and Kelly, I love the show. I'm sorry I can't come today, but I'll try to come next time if I can. Well, now, there's an excuse. I had a great time at all of the shows I went to. I'm sorry, but I have to go now. Love, Nikki. And you
Aww,
remember Nikki. Nikki. Nikki is our darling sweetheart friend.
She's
our
a
little
doll.
Girl.
A little girl. She came
yeah,
up here once before.
A little girl
before.
Who came
doll.
Out on the last program, as a matter of fact, and said hello to us all.
And
she has been
handwriting.
She has been a faithful friend all along.
She goes to school. Where's the camera? Which one? I want to show this right. handwriting. Local teacher.
Okay.
Where is it?
Somebody. At this point...
I just wanted to show off
I know,
the,
I understand. I
the
appreciate
great educational
at this
value
point,
of Mendocino.
I would like to introduce to you all to an aspect of talent that many of you are not familiar with.
An aspect of talent?
An aspect
like
of talent, aspects. Yes. Louis the Vision Demetri.
Is that what the V for?
Yeah, that's what the V is for. Okay, Louis is going to sing for you tonight, and when Louis is done singing, then we're going to come back and talk to Louis for a minute and find out more about the many things that he does. So, Louis, your turn, I think.
Okay,
go
thank you,
it,
Bob.
Louis.
We're going to sing a song. I'm going to sing a song that we wrote here. Garth and Steve and I and Dan Paul. And it's a song about a guy and his relationship with his invisible girlfriend. Okay, ready? Eyes all aglow, and her actions are teasing with expressions that shows him the way to love her, shows him the way to her heart. She lets him know when the time is right. She never leaves him feeling uptight. She's the only one like that he knows. She calls him up of the night, tells him pick up your pen and write, pick up that guitar and play, get in the groove and sail away, sail away. When he's riding high, she's there for the ride. When he's down and out, she's there by his side. This insatiable girl, he carries a love in her heart. He can't hold back, he can't conceal, 'cause what she feels he knows is real. And she's the only one like that he knows. She calls him up in the middle of the night, tells him pick up that pen and write, pick up that guitar and play, get in the groove and sail away, sail away. Pick up your pen and write, pick up that guitar and play, get in the groove and sail away, sail away, sail away, sail away, sail away, sail away.
Thank you.
All right.
All right. Sail away.
Amazing. Come on over here, Louie.
All right.
Lou gets to sit down now.
Well, this is really exciting.
Works too. Yeah, it is. I mean, all the time you spend over there playing the keyboards and kind of off camera and not many of us knew that you were a singer.
Oh, yeah.
And I understand, ooh.
Thanks.
And producer and sound engineer.
And many things, yeah.
And friend of all those guys. Now that's quite a legacy.
I wouldn't brag about that if I were you, you know.
What a band. Let's have a hand for the band.
I love the band.
These guys are hot. They look good. We used to be a local band, and we couldn't make it around Mendocino.
How'd you spell that? Local.
Both, actually.
Thank
loco.
You.
Right.
Local. Right.
And a little poetry.
Then it got changed to Louie Louie.
Anyway, we couldn't make any money around here because all the tourists came in and they wouldn't let us rock and roll, so we moved to New York.
Can anybody?
And we've been
any
playing there.
Movie. Can anybody make any money around here?
Oh, I don't know, but we couldn't, so we moved to New York, and now we're back, and we're happy to be on the show. We're the Big Hairs.
And looking good.
You're the Big Hairs tonight?
The Big Hairs.
The Big Hairs band.
Garth, you've got to come over here.
He will. He'll come later. No, he's scheduled.
Hey, you know,
he's
okay.
Garth is scheduled.
Garth has got a great joke. Are you going to tell that joke?
Oh, no, not that joke.
I can't tell that.
You wouldn't do that, would you? Yeah, no, I don't think you want to tell that joke, but later, we'll give you a chance. I heard the other one. Anyway, Louie.
Oh, Bob.
We want to know more about you.
Okay.
Okay. All of a sudden, surprised you sing. Now, we know that you are also an engineer, right? You do audio engineering.
What about drumming?
Drumming, yeah. Sometimes, yeah.
What is it you don't do?
Golf.
I don't play golf.
You don't play golf. I knew this.
I'd like to. It looks pretty fun.
He's a hell of a caddy, isn't he? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well. There must be the haircut.
Well, we can do the same for him in the studio.
No, we've been working hard, all seriousness aside.
What brought you into the music business? I mean, it's a stupid question, but everybody who I ask that question to has a different answer. So sometimes I think maybe it's not such a stupid question.
It is, I think, a stupid question.
It really is.
Really?
But besides that, okay. I'll try to answer it. Well, instead of like going out and playing baseball, I took piano lessons. So then, you know, as I got into my middle life and I had to find an occupation, I thought I might as well be a piano player as like opposed to a professional baseball player.
Now,
sure, since
no
golf was suffering, you might
no
as well.
No
slur, you know,
on baseball if you don't
no
what is yours?
No slur on baseball.
Is your husband a baseball player?
No.
Sure.
Tell us what you've been doing.
Okay, well, we've been writing songs a lot, writing new songs. That was one of them.
We?
Yeah.
All of them?
All of us,
well,
yeah.
Who be we?
Who be we?
Can you
yeah.
Scoot well, back there with the blue hair, the drummer,
yeah.
And the pink the hair back there?
Yeah, he looks good. He's a mofoco.
The other Louie plays drums sometimes, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Guy plays the bassoon. Garth and Steve double on cellos.
Sure.
See,
we
play chamber music, too, in the afternoon.
Right. At 2 in the afternoon?
Yeah.
Chamber music, 2 in the afternoon.
Right. Big Hair playing Bach concerto in C minor.
Okay.
No, but
listen.
And let's
can
see.
Can we assure us now?
Garth and Bugs have a new record.
They do.
Tape action.
A
really?
New record.
Really?
Yeah.
7,400 pogo jumps in an hour, right? Okay. All right. Listen, we got to wind this up because we have to jump to the next commercial.
Sure.
This is a very important
cut me
thing.
Off. No, it's okay.
No, I can't cut you off. You can only cut yourself
it's
off.
Okay.
Okay.
Do it.
Yeah, I'll cut
Thanks.
Me off. I'll cut me off. I gotta
we'll
go over
back.
There and play, though.
We'll be back.
Okay.
Can I hold this?
Ready?
All right. One, two, a one, two, three, four, one.
Today on Lawnmowers of the Rich and Famous, we're at the summer home of Robert Redford. We're here to interview Washington Ingram Newsom III, or Winsome, as his friend calls him. Winsome holds a master's degree in horticulture and a PhD in business finance.
Well, Winsome, it's great to be here today interviewing you for Lawnmowers of the Rich and Famous. How is it working for Bob Redford?
Bob's a good guy. I like working for Bob a lot.
Hey, stupid!
Excuse me. One second, I have to take a little call here, huh?
Yeah. Sell. Just sell. That's it. Bye.
Gosh, a lot of things
hey,
going
stupid.
On when you're working,
Oh, the job. Sorry. Another phone call here, you know how it is. Hey, hello. Yeah, bye. I think we should buy that, yeah. Okay, yeah, goodbye.
Well, I can see you're a busy man, Winsome, but tell us, what's the best part of working for Mr. Redford?
Well, Robin, I think it's probably the $250,000 a year, you know?
I see what you mean.
You know, you can't beat that.
You can't beat that. I'd like to get a job here myself, but I do lawnmowers of the rich and famous, and they
hey, stupid. As well.
Oh, hey, excuse me. Hello? Yeah. Yeah, that's me. Sell.
Winsome, are you done yet? We want to take a hot tub. Could you please hurry along?
Sure, Bob. No problem, okay. Huh?
Good day.
Okay.
Yeah, what's he paying you for anyway?
Double drums, that's exciting. Yeah.
I can't do it.
Do we have a special guest to introduce right now?
Oh, yeah. We really do.
Okay, I guess we're back.
No, I'm really excited to have the honor of introducing this guy that's coming on. No, he's really, really good, and he's done a lot for the community, and he's done a lot for me. And he's like this, he's carpenter, and he's a producer. Bob, get up. Try, and he's he's really good. He's really good, I swear, you guys, he's really good. No, he like sings, and he dances, and
He's a surf slut.
He surfs, and I'm getting to it, don't rush me. Some people are so bossy, I can't believe it. No, he's really good, and he's a really nice guy, and everybody really likes him a lot. And his name is Michael Evans, and if you could please help me give him a warm welcome of surprise and applause. Okay, and be excited about it, because we're glad he's here with us, and he's going to talk about producing the Now and Then show. Let's have a big round of applause for Mike Evans. I meant it. I really did. I'm
Oh, God.
I wish you
break.
Would.
Come on.
Get some help in this corner. Yeah, Sally Stewart comes to the rescue.
I mean, look, he's got shine.
Oh, God.
Shine.
This is just such jive.
Shine. Okay. Stop camera.
Bob,
come on, we're making Bob go to sleep.
Oh, Bob, wake up, darling.
No, Mike, we're really glad that you could join us tonight. It's a pleasure having you, really, it is.
Thanks, Sally. I couldn't have gone on without that.
Nice to meet you. No, really, Mike. So, Mike, tell us, Mike.
Yes.
What have you been doing? And you know, when Bob was introducing you to everybody, he said, Mike O. O. B.
Evans.
Yeah. So Obi-Wan. Could you enlighten us to what that meant? Bob,
could I elaborate on that? What
nice
the OB
sweatshirt.
Stands for? Yeah. Nice. Really. Sun. Sun Welly.
I've seen one of these.
Sun Welly.
No,
you
boy.
Get that?
Snow was really
like
good.
It.
Hey, man.
The snow was really good. Okay. Well.
Where'd you get this? I want to mention names on this. Where'd you get this?
Where did I get this? I got this in Sun Valley.
Well, I have one like it. Willie Boyce has one. Tim Pellman has one.
Yeah, I know all why you have one,
we have
too,
some
so.
Serious
okay.
questions
you have good
for
friends.
You tonight.
I do.
Serious questions.
Yeah, real serious
Bummer.
Questions. So 2 years. 2 years, right?
2 years, what?
2 years.
Oh, the show, yeah.
I'm sorry.
It's been a lot of fun, Mike, and thanks for and the food is great,
yeah.
Huh, Bam? Salami.
Yeah.
The food is hot.
The floor
is
open
is
to questions.
Yeah?
I got one. What's the next step if this is the last show?
Who said that?
The next step, this is the last show. Well,
No, are you saying this is the last show?
Well, I just don't want to produce it anymore.
Get a grip.
What?
What else is there to do?
Well, I'm going
to
produce a movie about Mendo.
Well, when I said earlier OB, remember when I said Michael OB Evans? You know what that is? Oral Baker.
What, have I eat a lot of donuts or what?
No, no.
Like,
come on. Come on now, you
no,
know.
No, actually, the reason I can't do the show anymore is the big director in the sky in the big control room up there told me that if I don't raise $10,000 by the end of the month, I'm going to have to move. He's not going to take me home. He's going to make me move. If you don't want me to move, send him the money. Just $10,000 just by the end of the month. No problem. I have never been in a sex scandal.
What's the...
I've never driven a Rolls Royce. Hey, my rent is really cheap on my house.
Yeah. Well, Mike, I'll
Mike,
keep my ears open for a place for you.
You are the sex scandal. That's what.
Sun Welly. No, actually, I want to do a movie. I want to produce something else.
Oh,
I mean,
sure.
This is great doing it with everybody, and it's amazing we've gone 2 years, huh? 2 years.
I haven't
2 years.
I can't believe that.
Actually, 3 years ago, Louie and Doug Nunn, who's going to be on later, and I got together 3 years ago and wrote the original script for the Now and Then show, and then went and did our own projects for a whole year, and finally, then a year later,
I remember that. And
got together
see an excerpt
and did it
from that. You know, right about now, aren't we?
Sure. Let's put it on.
Okay. So mainly, the whole show is trying to. It's a variety talk show that will have comedy, real people on a local. People that have been here all their whole life, old, real old people, and people who lived here, you know, what, 15 years, 10 years, 20 years, 25 years, 80 years, you know. And also, I want to get counterpoint people on different types of people who have different opinions about everything. People from Fort Bragg talking to people about Mendocino, about growth and things like that. I have the supervisors on sometimes when it's necessary. And,
it's always necessary.
Well, see, here we got.
Have you ever seen them on?
Of you. No. Actually, they were on my show once.
I think I'm beginning to understand, though. What we're talking about here is radio with visuals.
Visuals. But so we have.
That I can deal with.
With comedy, local musicians.
Local locals.
And musicians and anybody else who. Poets.
That was great, wasn't it? I love it when they do this. Yeah. So anyway,
the magic of television.
It's been really good.
No, but like this movie, what's this movie gonna be about?
And actually, I got a great idea for two couples and this sort of philosophical guy who does irate comments on everything, you know. Well, one couple has an RV and they meet in the bar. They're tourists. And they invite the local couple to go out to lunch with him on the headlands. And along the way, they pick
up not gonna tell us
in
joke.
The bar, they get... they
I
pick
resign.
Up this other guy. And
I
Bob's
quit.
One of my couples.
I can handle that all by myself.
No, he's my philosophical guy I'm going to have.
So,
Yes, Kel.
What do you like do for, like, money? Cut it out. I'm Mary John. Up and baseball is practice.
You do that, Mr. Don't. Sanger. I blew it. Uh-oh, baseball to the head now. Okay. So.
No, so like, what are you doing? Like, if you're not going to do this and you're not going to do that movie right away, what do you do for money? Somebody has to pay for the salami and the show and the
mineral water and the
I told
ships.
You, the big director in the big control room in the sky the strokes, told me right? I had to get more money.
Okay, folks, you heard it. You heard it right here. $10,000 by the end of the month.
Or he's I have to move.
Checking out.
Where is it you live, Michael?
I live in Little River. Nice little place. Little good resort area. You should try it.
Hey, Mike. Did you know that Tammy Baker OD'd?
I live with him. His roommate's here in the audience.
Did you, mascara.
Did you know that? Mascara, man. Yeah, she OD'd on mascara. Well, okay.
Tell us some more lies, Mike.
I'm not going to say anything more.
Lies. More lies.
One question. If I send you some money, will you spend it in accordance to the Constitution? Have you ever read the Constitution of the United States?
You bet your life.
No, no, no. We're talking about the Constitution and the now and then. You know?
Yeah.
So, Mike, what
I'm out here. I'm out here directing. Okay, ready. We're going to go to the band now.
Wait. I like this. When you put the show together, I want to know who the artist is that put those now and then. The end.
Bugs? Did you do those, Bugs?
Those two.
Did Button do those?
They're really nice.
It was Bugs.
Bugs did
and
it.
Credit due to the,
Bugs
to
did
to
it.
Karen, didn't Karen?
Oh, and the backdrop. Karen Falcon did the backdrop. Work, yeah, it was a great backdrop.
Really better,
so anyway, we want to get.
You want to get some money?
No. Well, we already everybody knows that. And at the end of the month, if I don't have $10,000, I'm out of here. So, doesn't you know? That's just the way it is.
I need. Boy.
I mean, Oral Baby did it.
Oral Mike.
Oral Bob. Hey, Bob. Kel Bob. Oral Bob. Okay, so anyway.
I like it.
Don't, the directory. Mike, we want to ask you some more personal questions. Where'd you get these nice shoes? Do you run in those shoes, Mike? How do you keep so physically fit to do this show? It's a emotionally and physically and psychically draining job, as we all know, those of us who... dedicate ourselves
did you do
to
something?
Yeah, you be careful, Kelly. He's gonna swear a blue streak.
I feel like
soon.
Dancing.
Let's dance. You know, we can't raise money, so we might as well dance.
Anyway, sure. Thanks for being with us, Mike.
Hey, thanks for having me on
Michael,
the show.
It was really good.
It's been great, man.
We really are glad that you're here with us.
Okay.
We appreciate it.
See you around.
Okay.
Yeah. Our kind of guy, man.
Yeah, let's
right. Let's get down.
Let us put men and women together, see which one is smarter. Some say men, but I say no. Women got the man like a puppet show. It ain't me, it's the people that say men are leading women astray. But I say it's the women today, smarter than a man in every way. That's right, the women are smarter. That's right, the women are smarter. A little boy sat down and cried. Old man passing asked him why. He said, I can't do what them big boys do. Old man sat down, he cried too. It ain't me, it's the people that say men are leading women astray. But I say, it's the women today, smarter than a man in every way. That's right, that's right. It ain't me, it's the people that say men are leading women astray. But I say, it's the women today, smarter than a man in every way. That's right, the women are smarter. That's right, the women are smarter. That's right, the women are smarter. Smarter than a man in every way. That's right! Welcome to Soul Train. Get down with Bad Bob. That's all.
Are we back?
I think so. Yeah.
Are you on? Are we on? Are we on?
What the hell are we doing now?
No, really, it really upset me because Mike said that when we were up there dancing and stuff, he said that I was really slow and he wanted to know what was wrong with me, like I was really boring or something, you know, and I couldn't explain it. I was just saying, you know, I was talking about you, Mike. What do you want? God. It's hot, you know, it's not easy being
being the co-host of the Now and Then.
Oh, tell me about it.
Help! I'm drowning. What's next?
Hell, I don't know what's next.
What are we going to do now?
Let's consult the script.
Debra, the belly dance.
No, Garth.
Never mind, Kelly, take a powder. She doesn't know what she's saying.
It's my turn to introduce now.
Go. Good, we're not on air. We don't care. Nice air.
We are. We're here. We're bad. All right.
We're big.
What's happening right now, if you're catching up with... Oh, my God.
Sing it to me, Garth.
It's going to be our pleasure on the Now and Then Show on our second anniversary to introduce to you the animal of the Western world, Mr. Garth Beckington, who is going not only to play... He's not only going to play...
These folks can really dance out
here. Yeah.
I could really get into your hair.
It's really nice to be on slow jam.
Nice hair. Looks good. Nice suit.
Nice hair.
Nice Big shoes.
Hair.
Nice guitar.
Yeah. Ensemble is good, man. He's going to sing, too.
That's right. It goes like this, ladies and gentlemen. This is on the next release.
I say, go for it. Give me life or give me Garth.
For your mama, baby, but I ain't got a thing for you. I got a thing for your mama, baby, but I ain't got a thing for you. That's 'cause your mama's good looking and I can't say the same for you. I get everything from your mama, but I don't get a thing from you. I get everything from your mama, but I don't get a thing from you. That's 'cause your mama's good looking. I can't say the same about you. But I ain't got a thing for you. I got a thing for your mama, but I ain't got a thing for you. That's 'cause your mama good looking and I can't say the same for you. I got a thing for your mama. I got a thing for your mama. I got a thing for your mama. Mama, I got a thing for your mama, but I ain't got a thing for you.
Oh, hot stuff.
Come on over here and sit down. Wait, we're back. Oh my, okay.
Garthy, come on.
Well, if you can. You can get it here.
Yeah, bring your guitar.
All right.
Hey, Bugsy, come on. It wouldn't be the same really without you.
How are you doing, Bugs?
Oh. We've done a lot of work.
Wait a minute. How you doing, man? Hey, how's it at, man? You know?
It's great.
It's nice to see you.
Wow. I love this guy. Oh. Hi, Garth. Okay.
Well, it really looks different from this angle, Bob. I can see why you kept the job so long, you know?
Bugarth.
My name's not Bob, anyway.
No, it's Bugarth. Great. Yeah.
I've used these before.
Now, listen, you guys are ostensibly musicians, right?
Ostensibly, yeah.
No, in fact. Word and deed.
In fact? Not even ostensible.
I would never do anything ostensible. Anyway, you know what I mean.
I know, I resemble that.
Him
too.
Either. Yeah. Terrible.
How long have you known each other and been in partnership with buds?
Well,
don't get
question.
Personal.
We've never been in partnership. We've never been friends. We hate each other. And,
I know that
Tomorrow I'll never see him for like about 4 months.
Kelly, we do this for the money, you know that.
I know. Thanks, Mike, again for the salami and the chips and the salsa.
They do this for the hair job.
Yeah, that was big of you, Mike. Thanks for the chips.
Big of you, yeah.
Hell, they only do it for the hair job. That's it.
Chocolate chip cookies and salami.
I mean, what else do they get? What else do they get when they show up here and perform night after night after night?
Great head job.
Great head job. You get a great head job. All right. Are you happy with your lives?
I would be happier if I was Don King, but we got the same hairdresser.
I was a lot happier after my head job, of course.
Listen, if we can raise $10,000 in the next 30 days, you guys will come back, right?
$10,
yeah.
Absolutely.
Would you? Question, though, before you go.
Come back for $50.
Very quickly, because we have a commercial pressing. We have a commercial pressing upon our very, very veins.
That's not true. That's a lie.
It's getting to me, too, Bob.
No, the time is imminent, man. We have to move along.
We're going to have a lot of fun, okay? Now, come on, everyone.
All right. One last statement.
No, sorry.
This is it. We're
hey. Quit it.
Okay.
Last
word. You get sunglasses in this group.
We'll be right back.
Buy it by the box.
Forget
Stay
it,
with us. We'll be right back.
Now, a word from Mikey Rooney.
Don't you just love it when a bunch of people do something they're proud of and then slap themselves on the back for doing it? Sort of a mutual admiration demonstration. Very similar to an award show. As if anyone cares what their friends set out to do, much less accomplish. I have to laugh when I witness self-aggrandizement. It's as if these people struggle to reach their goal just to look around to see who's looking. And when they found that only their self was looking, they patted their self on the back and said, good job. But then again, whatever furthers one's journey.
Special treat for you right now on the Now and Then show, and you're going to tell us about it, aren't you?
Yes. Please welcome the beautiful and magnificent Debra Fischbach. She is being accompanied by her husband Ernest, and the famous Suki is a local well-known drummer, teacher, artist extraordinaire of Mendocino, and they're going to give us a real special treat in honor of our second anniversary. So,
all right,
please
let's
welcome
go.
Debra.
Thank you.
few things?
Yeah,
come
why don't
up,
you come talk
please.
To us for a minute? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
Have a seat. Here, just make sure we put this up. You do it.
Yeah.
Just want to ask you a few questions. That was beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
How do you do that?
You can't think.
Oh, it's beautiful.
No, I can't imagine. It gives me gas just to think about it.
There's no thinking allowed.
No, how did you learn to do that?
Well, I started out being a drummer, accompanying dancers with my husband.
Ernest over there. Accompanying.
And Suki.
You know what I mean. And Suki too.
Yes.
That's neat. So where does belly dancing originate?
Well, where does music originate? I don't know. Persia, maybe?
No, we were trying to figure that out. Morocco came to mind.
Morocco.
But in ancient earth, there was something before Morocco, right?
Yeah, the Persians don't claim it, but I'm sure they had some.
It is lovely, really beautifully, and you do it so well. What does this gold thing symbolize around your neck?
Well, believe it or not, this is a drink ticket from a private opening of the Tut exhibit.
All right.
Where I danced.
So did you dance for the young prince, old King Tut?
Oh, huh? I wouldn't tut that with a 10-foot pole.
Leave it to Bob.
Oh, my, okay.
So that was beautiful. Do you make your own costume and everything?
Yes, I made everything but the pants.
It's lovely. And Ernest, how long have you been playing with your wife here? I can't believe I said that.
I can't believe she said that.
You're all sick.
Gosh.
I've been playing this kind of music for about 15 years.
What is that musical instrument called over there?
This is called a jumbush.
Istanbul.
Istanbul. Yeah, right.
And Suki, what's that thing that you have there?
This is a dumbek. This particular one is from southern Morocco.
Very good.
I saw you had it wrapped or something. You have to keep it warm? Or?
Yes, you do. It has a fish skin head. Real fish skin.
Some of the band has that problem, too.
Oh, this subliminal innuendo going on here is making me crazy.
And the hat that Bob has, the honorary hat, where does this come from?
That's from Marrakesh, Morocco.
Oh,
yeah.
Where do you come from?
Mendocino. Your imagination, Suki.
No, as long as I have this on, it's the old street joke, you know. Old money, pay me some.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. I understand that. We're going to take a little dance break now.
Yeah, well, thank you for being
here,
Debra. That was lovely. Suki and
Can
Ernest,
we dance?
That was good work. You guys.
Would you
beautiful.
Put me on your dance ticket?
You're dancing, yes.
Yes, wonderful. Here we go.
Bob did so enjoy it when you wrapped it around.
Dance. Now we're going to dance. While we dance, we'll be right back.
And Doug and Tracy are next.
Doug and Tracy are coming up.
Doug and Tracy, yep. Stick around.
Ladies and gentlemen, life is a decision-making process. All day long, we are confronted with decisions to make. The first one I make every morning is heavy beer, and I feel like $1.98 all day long. You dig?
And a final statement from Mikey Rooney.
I just wanted to congratulate all the people who helped produce the Now and Then Show on their second anniversary. Not many money-losing productions continue for such a long period of time. I'm sure it's only because of the love locals have for manifesting a common vision solely intended for the entertainment of their friends that such a creation could even occur. I, for one, enjoyed the demonstration of cooperation. I'd like to thank all the volunteers who helped make the show for the last 2 years. This is Mikey Rooney saying thank you. Without you, I wouldn't even be doing this. And I guess now, without you, I won't be doing this.
The double-double band, right? Yeah, okay.
Yes.
Well, we're coming close to the end of the show tonight.
Who's next? Let's go. Let's have them. Let's have them out here. Who is it? Who's it going to be?
You're a sick person, Kelly.
I can see him over there.
I can see him over there, too. But they can't see them yet. This is our second anniversary. And it's kind of a melancholy moment. And the way to close out a melancholy moment is with some wild, insane, wonderful humor. So we have to, at this point, welcome Nunn and Burn.
Burns and Nunn, Tracy and Doug.
Burns and Nunn, here they are.
No beer, my dinner's cold, and you ain't even naked yet. But we still got us 5 minutes before game time. We could have us some nookie.
Hold it right there, big boy. The same old orders, the same stupid demands. Doesn't it just make you wish cucumbers could lift heavy objects? Well, women, throw your cares away and welcome the all-new household hobby hubby, the perfect house husband for the 80s. He'll clean the house, take care of the kids, wash the dishes, and take out the garbage, all without whining. And unlike your present mate, hobby hubby comes equipped with an odor and noise filter. No more B.O., no more loud farts. And he doesn't even like sports.
Monday night football? Forget it, honey. Let's watch All My Children again.
And just look at these wonderful accessories. Our special dial-a-mate allows you to tune in the exact kind of caring, feeling man you want. From humane, cultured, KQED liberal, to passionate, hairy-chested, third-world revolutionary. Ooh, you can be sure your man will keep you happy. And with his built-in macho stopper and 28-day sensitivity timer, rest assured he'll sympathize with you at that time of the month.
I understand, dear. Oh, me too.
And last but not least, he comes fully equipped to carry your child. So move over, Stepford Wives. It's Hobby Hubby. Hobby Hubby, the ultimate house husband for the 80s from Femtronics.
Thank you.
Thanks, dudes.
Come on, we have to have a little encore. Can you do it sitting down?
Can we do it sitting down?
Sure.
That's your microphone,
honey.
No, I'm talking about can you do comedy sitting down?
Hot stuff, who wrote that?
They did.
The brains about it.
I love it.
Yeah.
Burns?
Burns and Brains.
Burns and
Nunn. Burns.
Yeah.
Close, very close.
Very
dude.
Close, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. I admire you.
And we admire you, too.
Yeah, I mean, your hair, it's colored, and our hair.
Listen, my hair and my whole style tonight matches my tie. I have a little blue, red, and gray.
Sure,
it's all there.
It's a fabulous look. It really is.
Thank you. Thank you.
See, like, where are you guys living? What are you doing? And, like, how much do you pay for rent? And do you have a good car now? And what?
No, we crashed the car, but we have wonderful rent in San Francisco, as all apartments in San Francisco are such great rents.
Bargains, right?
Big bargains,
yeah.
Where are you appearing next?
We're appearing this weekend, actually, at Crown Hall in Mendocino here. We're doing a show called Springtime for Laugh Fest with Patty Morrissey this weekend. I guess when the show airs, Loose Change will be up. And they're a comedy improv group from San Francisco.
Yeah, who's so,
hot tamales? Where is Patty Morrissey from?
He's from San Francisco. He's actually from Louisville originally. Yeah. We were just touring with him in Oregon for the last 10 days, so he's a great comedian. He does a great Ronald Reagan impression, and amongst many other things.
That's me. We want to thank you very much for being here tonight.
Thanks for having us.
Good luck this weekend.
Closing out our second anniversary show with such fine, rotund humor.
Yeah. Party at Bob's.
It's a great pleasure for
us
all.
Happy anniversary.
Can I take this little salt shaker?
We want to thank all of you, our wonderful audience, for being here tonight. And we want you to all give us a big rousing hand for
Nikki,
Nuns and Burns.
Burns and Nuns.
Yep. And Garth.
Yay.